This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Eastern role-playing video games are role-playing video games developed in East Asia, including Japan, South Korea, and, to a lesser extent, China. Contents 1 Japanese computer RPGs 11 Origins early 1980s 12 Golden Age late 1980s early 1990s 13 Decline and independent titles late 1990s present 2 Japanese console RPGs 21 Origins mid-1980s 22 Evolution late 1980s 23 Golden Age 1990s mid 2000s 231 early 1990s 232 late 1990s 233 early 2000s 234 mid 2000s 24 relative decline late 2000s 25 aftermath early 2010s 3 South Korean RPGs 31 1980s to 1990s 32 2000s present 4 Chinese RPGs 5 see also 6 references 7 further reading 8 external links Japanese computer RPG see also, action role-playing game and tactical role-playing game origins early 1980s Yamaha YIS-503 IIMSX personal computer while the Japanese video game industry has long been viewed as console-centric in the Western world, due to the worldwide success of Japanese consoles beginning with the NES, the country had in fact produced thousands of commercial personal computer games from the late 1970s up until the mid-1990s. In addition to doujin's soft independent games, the country's computer market was very fragmented at first. Lode Runner, for example, reportedly required 34 conversions to different hardware platforms. The market eventually became dominated by the NEC PC 8801. Towns, and MSX. Early Japanese RPG, Danchizuma no Yuaku Seduction of the Condominium Wife, a PC 8001 title that also featured adventure game elements in addition to eroge adult content. Another early Japanese RPG from 1982 was Pony Canyon Spy Daisakusen, based on the Mission Impossible franchise, replacing the traditional fantasy setting with a modern espionage setting in June 1983. Koei released Sword. Combining role-playing, turn-based grand strategy and management simulation elements, setting the standard for future simulation RPGs. This trend continued with its sequels and other Koei games such as 1989's Bandit Kings of Ancient China as well as the Capcom game Destiny of an Emperor released that same year. Also in 1983, Nihon Falcom released Panorama TOH Panorama Island for the PC 88. It was developed by Yoshio Kiya, who would go on to create the Dragon Slayer and Brandish series of action RPGs. While its RPG elements were limited, lacking traditional statistical or leveling systems, the game featured real-time combat with a gun, bringing it close to the action RPG formula that Falcom would later be known for. The game's Desert Island Overworld also featured a day-night cycle, non-player characters the player could attack or converse with, and the need to survive by finding and consuming rations to restore hit points lost with each normal action. Screenshot of the original NEC PC 8801 version of Hydlide 1984, an early action role-playing game in 1984, Nihon Falcom released Dragon Slayer, a historically significant title that laid the foundations for the Japanese role-playing game industry. It was a real-time hack and slash dungeon crawler that is considered the first action role-playing game, a subgenre that it laid the foundations for, alongside the arcade game The Tower of Druaga released the same year. Dragon Slayer was a major success in Japan, and led to the emergence of a distinct action role-playing game subgenre on Japanese computers during the mid-1980s, with Nihon Falcom at the forefront of this new subgenre. Dragon Slayer as well as the Tower of Druaga laid the foundations for future action RPG series like Hydlide, Wise and The Legend of Zelda Hydlide, released for the PC 8801 in 1984 and the Famicom in 1986, added several innovations to the action RPG subgenre, including the ability to switch between attack mode and defense mode, quick save and load options which can be done at any moment of the game through the use of passwords as the primary backup, and the introduction of a health regeneration mechanic where health and magic slowly regenerate when standing still, a feature also used in Falcom's Wise series from 1987 onwards. Also in 1984, Hank Rogers' The Black Onyx was released on the PC 8801 in Japan, where it became one of the best-selling computer games and was voted Game of the Year by Login, the largest Japanese computer game magazine at the time. The game is thus credited for bringing wider attention to computer role-playing games in the country. The cyberpunk RPG Psychic City, released by Hot B for the FM7 and PC8801 in 1984, departed from the fantasy theme common in other RPGs at the time, such as Hydlide and the Black Onyx, in favor of a science fiction plot, set in a post-apocalyptic city devastated by World War III and where the protagonist fights using psychic, telepathic abilities. The game later served as the basis for the 1987 NES RPG Hoshiwo Miruhito. Dragon Slayer's success led to a 1985 sequel, Dragon Slayer 2, Xanadu, which became the best-selling PC game in Japan. It was a full-fledged RPG with character stats and a large quest, with action-based combat setting it apart from other RPGs, including both melee combat and projectile magic attacks, while incorporating a side-scrolling platform game view during exploration and an overhead view during battle. Xanadu also featured innovative gameplay mechanics such as individual experience for equipped items, and an early karma morality system, where the player character's karma meter will rise if he commits sin, which in turn affects the temple's reaction to him. It is also considered a proto-metroidvania game, due to being an RPG turned on its side that allowed players to run, jump, collect, and explore. The way the Dragon Slayer series reworked the entire game system of each installment was an influence on Final Fantasy, which would do the same for each of its installments. According to GameStim and John Shapaniak of Retro Gamer and The Escapist, Enix's Dragon Quest was also influenced by Dragon Slayer and in turn defined many other RPGs. Falcom would soon become one of the three most important Japanese role-playing game developers in the 1980s, alongside Enix and Square, both of which were influenced by Falcom. Hydlide 2, Shine of Darkness in 1985 featured an early morality meter, where the player can be aligned with justice, normal, or evil, which is affected by whether the player kills evil monsters, good monsters, or humans, and in turn affects the reactions of the townsfolk towards the player. Magical Zeus the Screamer, released for the PC8801 in 1985, was an early example of a real-time shooter-based RPG set after World War III. The game also featured elements of post-apocalyptic science fiction as well as cyberpunk and bio-horror themes. Square also released their first RPG that same year, which was an early futuristic sci-fi RPG for the PC8801, Genesis, Beyond the Revelation, featuring a post-apocalyptic setting. Other sci-fi RPGs released in 1985 include the Earth Fighter Reyeza by Enix, and Kagado Studios' MSX game Cosmic Soldier, which introduced an early dialogue conversation system, where the player can recruit allies by talking to them, choose whether to kill or spare an enemy, and engage enemies in conversation, similar to the later more famous Megami Tensei Golden Age. Late 1980s, early 1990s. The late 1980s to early 1990s is considered the golden age of Japanese computer gaming, which would flourish until its decline around the mid-1990s, as consoles eventually dominated the Japanese market. A notable Japanese computer RPG from around this time was Weeberm, the earliest known RPG to feature 3D polygonal graphics. It was a 1986 role-playing shooter released by Arsys Software for the PC-88 in Japan and ported to MS-DOS for Western release by Broderbund. In Weeberm, the player controls a transformable mecha robot, switching between a 2D side-scrolling view during outdoor exploration to a fully 3D polygonal third-person perspective inside buildings, while bosses are fought in an arena-style 2D shoot-em-up battle. The game featured a variety of weapons and equipment as well as an automap, and the player could upgrade equipment and earn experience to raise stats, unlike first-person RPGs at the time that were restricted to 90-degree movements. Weeberm's use of 3D polygons allowed full 360-degree movement. Another 1986 release was Falcom's Xanadu Scenario 2, an early example of an expansion pack. The game was non-linear, allowing the 11 levels to be explored in any order. Dragon Slayer Jr. Romancia simplified the RPG mechanics of Xanadu, such as removing the character customization and simplifying the numerical statistics into icons, and emphasized faster-paced platform action, with a strict 30-minute time limit. The action took place entirely in a side-scrolling view view rather than switching to a separate overhead combat screen like its predecessor. These changes Romancia more like a side-scrolling action-adventure game. Square's 1986 release, Cruise Chaser Blasty, was a sci-fi RPG that had the player control a customizable mecha robot from a first-person view. That same year also saw the arcade release of the sequel to The Tower of Druaga, The Return of Ishtar, an early action RPG to feature two-player cooperative gameplay, dual-stick control in single-player, a female protagonist, the first heroic couple in gaming, and the first password save system in an arcade game in 1987. Dragon Slayer IV, Drazel Family Legacy of the Wizard returned to the deeper action RPG mechanics of Xanadu while maintaining the fully side-scrolling view of Romancia. It also featured an open world and non-linear gameplay similar to Metroidvania platform adventures, making Drazel Family an early example of a non-linear, open world action RPG. Another Metroidvania style open world action RPG released that year was System Sacom's Sharp X1 computer game Euphoria, which was possibly the only Metroidvania-style multiplayer action RPG produced, allowing two-player cooperative gameplay. The fifth Dragon Slayer title, Sorcerian, was also released in 1987. It was a party-based action RPG, with the player controlling a party of four characters at the same time in a side-scrolling view. The game also featured character creation, highly customizable characters, class-based puzzles, and a new scenario system, allowing players to choose which of 15 scenarios, or quests, to play through in the order of their choice. It was also an episodic video game, with expansion discs released soon after offering more scenarios. Falcom also released the first installment of its popular, long-running Wise series in 1987. Besides Falcom's own Dragon Slayer series, Wise was also influenced by Hydlide, from which it borrowed certain mechanics such as health regeneration when standing still, a mechanic that has since become common in video games. Today, Wise was also a precursor to RPGs that emphasize storytelling, and it is known for its bump attack system, where the protagonist Adol automatically attacks when running into enemies off-center, making the game more accessible and the usually tedious level grinding task more swift and enjoyable for audiences. At the time, the game also had what is considered to be one of the best and most influential video game music soundtracks of all time, composed by Yuzo Koshiro and Miko Ishikawa. In terms of the number of game releases, Wise is second only to Final Fantasy as the largest Eastern role-playing game franchise. Hydlide 3, The Space Memories, released for the MSX in 1987 and for the Mega Drive as Super Hydlide in 1989, adopted the morality meter of its predecessor, expanded on its time option with the introduction of an in-game clock setting day-night cycles and a need to sleep and eat, and made other improvements such as cutscenes for the opening and ending, a combat system closer to The Legend of Zelda, the choice between four distinct character classes, a wider variety of equipment and spells, and a weight system affecting the player's movement depending on the overall weight of the equipment. Carried that same year, Kagato Studios' sci-fi RPG Cosmic Soldier, Psychic War featured a unique tug-of-war style real-time combat system, where battles are a clash of energy between the party and the enemy, with the player needing to push the energy towards the enemy to strike them, while being able to use a shield to block or a suction ability to absorb the opponent's power. It also featured a unique non-linear conversation system, where the player can recruit allies by talking to them, choose whether to kill or spare an enemy, and engage enemies in conversation, similar to Megami Tensei. Also in 1987, Shiryu Senshin, War of the Dead, an MSX2 title developed by Fun Factory and published by Victor Music Industries, was the first true survival horror RPG designed by Katsuya Iwamoto. The game revolved around a female SWAT member Lila rescuing survivors in an isolated monster-infested town and bringing them to safety in a church. It was open-ended like Dragon Quest and had real-time side-view battles like Zelda 2, unlike other RPGs at the time. However, the game had a dark and creepy atmosphere expressed through the story, graphics, and music, while the gameplay used shooter-based combat and gave limited ammunition for each weapon, forcing the player to search for ammo and often run away from monsters in order to conserve ammo. That same year saw the release of Laplace No Ma, another hybrid of survival horror and RPG, though with more traditional RPG elements such as turn-based combat. It was mostly set in a mansion infested with undead creatures, and the player controlled a party of several characters with different professions, including a scientist who constructs tools and a journalist who takes pictures. Star Cruiser 1988, an early role-playing shooter, combined first-person shooter and role-playing game elements along with 3D polygon graphics. In 1988, Arsys Software's Star Cruiser was an innovative action RPG released for the PC-8801. It was notable for being an early example of an RPG with fully 3D polygonal graphics, combined with first-person shooter gameplay, which would occasionally switch to space flight simulator gameplay when exploring outer space with 6 degrees of freedom. All the backgrounds, objects and opponents in the game were rendered in 3D polygons, many years before they were widely adopted by the video game industry. The game also emphasized storytelling, with plot twists and extensive character dialogues. Taking place in a futuristic science fiction setting, it won the 1988 Game of the Year awards from the Japanese computer game magazines POPCOM and OX. Star Cruiser was later ported to the Mega Drive console in 1990. Another 1988 release, Last Armageddon, produced for the PC-8801 and later ported to the PC Engine CD and NES consoles in 1990, featured a unique post-apocalyptic storyline set in a desolate future where humanity has become extinct and the protagonists are demon monsters waging war against an alien species. The Scheme, released by BothTech for the PC-8801 in 1988, was an action RPG with a similar side-scrolling open-world gameplay to Metroid that same year. Wise 2 introduced the unique ability to transform into a monster, which allows the player to both scare human non-player characters for unique dialogues as well as interact with all the monsters. This is a recurring highlight in the series, offering the player insight into the enemies, to an extent that very few other games allow to this day. Also that same year, War of the Dead Part 2 for the MSX2 and PC-88 abandoned certain RPG elements of its predecessor, such as random encounters, and instead adopted more action-adventure elements from Metal Gear while retaining the horror atmosphere of its predecessor. 1988 also saw the debut of Telenet Japan's Exile, a series of action platform RPGs, beginning with XZR, Idols of Apostate. The series was controversial for its plot, which revolves around a time-traveling Crusades era Syrian Islamic assassin who assassinates various religious, historical figures as well as modern-day political leaders, with similarities to the present-day Assassin's Creed action game series. The gameplay of Exile included both overhead exploration and side-scrolling combat, featured a heart monitor to represent the player's attack power and armor class statistics, and another controversial aspect of the game involved taking drugs instead of potions that decrease attributes but with side effects such as affecting the heart rate or causing death. An early attempt at incorporating a point-and-click interface in a real-time overhead action RPG was Silver Ghost, a 1988 NEC PC-8801 game by Kerr Software Kubu. It was an action-strategy RPG where characters could be controlled using a cursor. It was cited by Camelot Software Planning's Hiroyuki Takahashi as inspiration for the Shining series of tactical RPGs. According to Takahashi, Silver Ghost was a simulation action type of game where you had to oversee and command multiple characters. Unlike later tactical RPGs, however, Silver Ghost was not turn-based, but instead used real-time strategy and action role-playing game elements. A similar game released by Kerr Software Kubu that same year was First Queen, a unique hybrid between a real-time strategy, action RPG, and strategy RPG. Like an RPG, the player can explore the world, purchase items, and level up, and like a strategy video game, it focuses on recruiting soldiers and fighting against large armies rather than small parties. The game's Gochiakiara multiple characters system let the player control one character at a time while the others are controlled by computer AI that follow the leader, and where battles are large scale with characters sometimes filling an entire screen. Dragon Slayer: The Legend of Heroes in 1989 departed from the action-oriented gameplay of previous Dragon Slayer titles, and instead used a more traditional turn-based combat system. In 1990, Data East's Gate of Doom was an arcade action RPG that combined beat-em-up fighting gameplay with fantasy role-playing and introduced an isometric perspective. That same year, Enix released a unique biological simulation action RPG by Almanac that revolved around the theme of evolution, 46 Okunin Monogatari, a revised version of which was released in 1992 as Evo, Search for Eden. That same year, Alpha Denshi's Crossed Swords for the arcades combined the first-person beat-em-up gameplay of SNK's The Super Spy, released the same year with RPG elements, while replacing the first-person shooting with hack Hideo Kojima's SD Snatcher, while turn-based, abandoned random encounters and introduced an innovative first-person shooter-based battle system where firearm weapons each with different abilities and target ranges have limited ammunition and the player can aim at specific parts of the enemy's body with each part weakening the enemy in different ways. An auto-battle feature could also be enabled. Such a battle system has rarely been used since, though similar battle systems based on targeting individual body parts can later be found in Square's Vagrant Story 2000, Bethesda's Fallout 3 2008, and Nippon Ichi's Last Rebellion 2010. In 1991, Nihon Falcom's Brandish was an early overhead action RPG to use mouse controls, where the player could move forward, backward, turn, strafe and attack by clicking on boxes surrounding the player character. The 1991 Dragon Slayer title Lord Monarch departed from the action RPG gameplay of its predecessors, instead using an early form of real-time strategy gameplay. The erotic adult RPG Dragon Knight 3, released in 1991 for the PC 8801 and as Knights of Zentar for MS-DOS, introduced a unique pausable real-time battle system, where characters automatically attack based on a list of different AI scripts, though this meant the player had no control over the characters during battle other than to give commands for spells, item use, and AI routines. That same year, Arcus Odyssey by Wolf Team, now Namco Tales Studio, was an action RPG that featured an isometric perspective and cooperative multiplayer gameplay, the sequel to the first-person shooter role-playing game Star Cruiser. Simply called Star Cruiser 2, was released in 1992, for the PC 9821 and FM Towns Computers T. Strategy games continued their focus on the PC market in 1996. Night Slave was a shooter RPG released for the PC 98 that combined the side-scrolling shooter gameplay of Assault Suits Vakan and Gradius, including an armament system that employs recoil physics, with many RPG elements such as permanently leveling up the mecha and various weapons using power orbs obtained from defeating enemies, as well as storyline cutscenes. These cutscenes also occasionally contain lesbian adult content. Lastly, in the late 1990s, a new internet fad began, owing to simplistic software development kits such as the Japanese RPG Maker series 1988 onwards, influenced by console RPGs and based mostly on the gameplay and style of the SNES and Sega Genesis games. A large group of young programmers and aficionados across the world began creating independent console-style computer RPGs and sharing them online. An early successful example was Corpse Party 1996, a survival horror indie game created using the RPG Maker engine, much like the survival horror adventure games Clock Tower 1995 onwards and later Haunting Ground 2005. The player characters in Corpse Party lack any means of defending themselves. The game also featured up to 20 possible endings. However, the game would not be released in Western markets until 2011. In an interview with Game Daily in 2007, MTVN's Dave Williams remarked that games like this, user-generated, have been sort of under the radar for something that could be the basis of a business. We have the resources and we can afford to invest more. I think it's going to be a great thing for the consumer. Japanese console RPGs. See also, action role-playing game and tactical role-playing game origins. Mid-1980s, the earliest role-playing video game on a console was Dragonstomper on the Atari 2600. In 1982, Bokusuka Wars, originally released for the Sharp X1 computer in 1983, was ported to the NES console in 1985, and was a commercial success in Japan, where it laid the foundations for the tactical role-playing game subgenre. Other notable early console RPGs included ports of Namco's 1984 arcade action role-playing games, The Tower of Druaga, which was ported to the NES in 1985, and Dragon Buster, the first video game to feature a life meter called Vitality in-game, also ported to the NES in 1987. Dragon Quest 1986, which combined the overhead exploration of Ultima with the first-person menu-driven combat of Wizardry, created a streamlined gameplay format that made console RPGs accessible to a wider audience. In 1985, Yuji Horii and his team at Chunsoft began production on Dragon Quest Dragon Warrior after Enix published the game in early 1986. It became the template for future console RPGs. The game was influenced by the first-person random battles in Wizardry, the overhead movement in Ultima, and the mystery storytelling in Horii's own 1983 visual novel. Game Portopia serial murder case. Hori's intention behind Dragon Quest was to create a RPG that appeals to a wider audience unfamiliar with the genre or video games in general. This required the creation of a new kind of RPG that didn't rely on previous D way other than by being infested with monsters that can easily kill an unprepared player. This was balanced by the use of bridges to signify a change in difficulty and a new level progression that departed from D Pony Canyon. Other releases at the time were the action role-playing games Deadly Towers 1986 and Rygar 1987, which were notable as some of the first Japanese console RPGs to be released in North America, where they were well received for being a new kind of RPG that differed from both the console action adventures such as Castlevania, Trojan, and Wizards. Individual spells that required magic points, and combined sci-fi. Extra powerful attack. Castlevania 2, Simon's Quest was an action RPG that combined the platform action mechanics of the original Castlevania with the open world of an action adventure and RPG mechanics such as experience points. It also introduced a day-night cycle that affects when certain NPCs appear in certain locations and offered three possible multiple endings depending on the time it took to complete the game. Square's Cleopatra no Mahu was an adventure RPG with a unique plot revolving around archaeology. Square's original Final Fantasy for the NES introduced an experimental character creation system that allowed the player to create their own parties and assign different character classes to party members, who in turn evolved through an early class change system later in the game. It also featured unique concepts such as time travel, side view battles, with the player characters on the right and the enemies on the left, which soon became the norm for numerous console RPGs, and the use of transportation for travel, by ship, canoe, and even flying airship. While creating Final Fantasy, Hironobu Sakaguchi took inspiration from certain elements in Hayao Miyazaki's anime films, such as the airships being inspired by Castle in the Sky. Some of these 1987 releases proved popular and went on to spawn their own RPG franchises, particularly the Megami Tensei, Phantasy Star, and Final Fantasy series in particular. The Final Fantasy and Dragon Quest series remain popular today, Final Fantasy more so in the West and Dragon Quest more so in Japan. In 1988, Dragon Quest III introduced a character progression system allowing the player to change the party's character classes during the course of the game, and keep a character's stats and skills learned from previous classes. This class-changing system shaped the gameplay of future RPGs, especially the Final Fantasy series, while a similar class-changing system later also appeared in Wizardry V and VII. While the earlier Dragon Quest games were also non-linear, Dragon Quest III was the most substantial example of open-world gameplay among the early Dragon Quest games. It also allowed the player to swap characters in and out of the party at will, and another major innovation was the introduction of day-night cycles. Certain items, characters, and quests are only accessible at certain times of day. Final Fantasy II is considered the first true Final Fantasy game, introducing an emotional storyline, morally ambiguous characters, tragic events, and a story to be emotionally experienced rather than concluded from gameplay and conversations. It also replaced traditional levels and experience points with a new activity-based progression system, where the more you use a skill, the better you are with it, a mechanic that has been used in a number of later RPGs such as the Saga and Grandia series, Final Fantasy XIV, and the Elder Scrolls series. Final Fantasy II also featured open-ended exploration, and introduced an innovative dialogue system where keywords or phrases can be memorized and mentioned during conversations with NPCs, the theme of an evil empire. Against a small band of rebels similar to Star Wars, and the iconic Chocobo, a fictional creature inspired by Hayao Miyazaki's Nausicaa of the Valley of the Wind. That same year, World Court Tennis for the TurboGrafx-16 introduced a new form of gameplay, a unique tennis-themed sports RPG mode. Sega's Phantasy Star II 1989 was an important milestone in the genre, establishing conventions such as an epic, dramatic, character-driven storyline, and science fiction setting in 1989. Phantasy Star II for the Genesis established many conventions of the genre, including an epic, dramatic, character-driven storyline dealing with serious themes and subject matter, and a strategy-based battle system. Its purely science fiction setting was also a major departure for RPGs, which had previously been largely restricted to fantasy or science fantasy settings. The game's science fiction story was also unique, reversing the common alien invasion scenario by instead presenting Earthlings as the invading antagonists rather than the the defending protagonists, the game's strong characterization, and use of self-discovery as a motivating factor for the characters and the player, was a major departure from previous RPGs and had a major influence on subsequent RPGs such as the Final Fantasy series. It also made a bold attempt at social commentary years before the Final Fantasy series started doing the same. Capcom's Sweet Home for the NES introduced a modern Japanese horror theme and laid the foundations for the survival horror genre, later serving as the main inspiration for Resident Evil 1996. Like Resident Evil, Sweet Home featured the use of scattered notes as a storytelling mechanic and a number of multiple endings depending on which characters survived to the end. Tengai Makio, Zeria, released for the PC Engine CD that same year, was the first RPG released on CD-ROM and the first in the genre to feature animated cut scenes and voice acting. The game's plot was also unusual for its feudal Japan setting and its emphasis on humor. The plot and characters were inspired by the Japanese folk tale Jiraiya Goketsu Monogatari. The music for the game was also composed by noted musician Ryuichi Sakamoto. Also in 1989, the early enhanced remake Wise Eye gameplay, allowing up to 5 players to play simultaneously that year, also saw the release of Super Hydlide, the Mega Drive port of the 1987 MSX action RPG Hydlide 3, The Space Memories, which adopted the morality meter of its 1985 predecessor Hydlide 2, Shine of Darkness, where the player's alignment changes depending on whether the player kills humans, good monsters, or evil monsters, and expanded its predecessor's time option, which speeds up or slows down the gameplay, with the introduction of an in-game clock setting, day-night cycles, and a need to sleep and eat. It also made other improvements such as cut scenes for the opening and ending, a combat system closer to The Legend of Zelda, the choice between distinct character classes, and a weight system affecting the player's movement depending on the weight of carried equipment. The Final Fantasy Legend, the first in the Saga series, adopted Final Fantasy II's activity-based progression, expanding it with weapons that shatter with repeated use, and added new ideas such as a race of monsters that mutate depending on which fallen foes they consume. The game also introduced the concept of memento mori, with a theme revolving around death, while the plot consisted of loosely connected stories and side quests rather than an epic narrative. That same year, River City Ransom featured elements of both the beat-em-up and action RPG genres, combining brawler combat with many RPG elements, including an inventory, buying and selling items, learning new abilities and skills, needing to listen for clues, searching to find all the bosses, shopping in the malls, buying items to heal, and increasing stats. It was also an early sandbox brawler reminiscent of Grand Theft Auto. Golden Age 1990s mid-2000s. The Golden Age of console RPGs is often dated from the 1990s to the early 2000s. Console RPGs distinguished themselves from computer RPGs to a greater degree in the early 1990s as console RPGs became more heavily story-based than their computer counterparts. One of the major differences that emerged during this time was in the portrayal of the characters, with most American computer RPGs at the time having characters devoid of personality or background, as their purpose was to represent avatars which the player uses to interact with the world, in contrast to Japanese console RPGs which depicted intricately related characters who had distinctive personalities and traits, with many of them, such as Final Fantasy and Lufia, seeming to offer more of the traditional role-playing, with players assuming the roles of people who cared about each other, fell in love, or even had families. Romance in particular was a theme that was common in most console RPGs but alien to most computer RPGs at the time. Japanese console RPGs were also generally more faster-paced and action-adventure oriented than their American computer counterparts. The console RPG market became more profitable, which led to several American manufacturers releasing console ports of traditional computer RPGs such as Ultima, though they received mixed reviews due to console gamers at the time considering them to be not as exciting as the Japanese imports. During the 1990s, console RPGs had become increasingly dominant, exerting a greater influence on computer RPGs than the other way around. Console RPGs had eclipsed computer RPGs for some time, though computer RPGs began making a comeback towards the end of the decade with interactive choice-filled adventures. During this era, Japanese RPGs gained recognition for being one of the very few video game genres to emphasize storytelling, which was considered revolutionary at the time, though this is no longer the case in recent years, as storytelling has now become commonplace for a majority of blockbuster video games, including action games early 1990s. In 1990, Dragon Quest IV introduced a new method of storytelling, segmenting the plot into segregated chapters. While this made the game more linear than its predecessor, it allowed for greater characterization, with each chapter dedicated to a particular character's background story. The game also introduced an AI system called Tactics, which allowed the player to modify the strategies used by the allied party members while maintaining full control of the hero. This Tactics system is seen as a precursor to Final Fantasy XII's Gambit's system. Final Fantasy III introduced the classic job system, a character progression engine allowing the player to change the character classes, as well as acquire new and advanced classes and combine class abilities. During the course of the game, that same year also saw the release of Nintendo's Fire Emblem, Ankoku Ryu to Hikari no Tsurugi, a game that set the template for the tactical role-playing game genre and was the first entry in the Fire Emblem series. Another notable strategy RPG that year was Koei's Bandit Kings of Ancient China, which was successful in combining the strategy RPG and management simulation genres, building on its own Nobunaga's Ambition series that began in 1983. Several early RPGs set in a post-apocalyptic future were also released that year, including Digital Devil Story, Megami Tensei II, and Crystalis, which was inspired by Hayao Miyazaki's Nausicaä of the Valley of the Wind. Crystalis also made advances to the action role-playing game subgenre, being a true action RPG that combined the real-time action-adventure combat and open world of The Legend of Zelda with the level build and spell casting of traditional RPGs like Final Fantasy. That year also saw the release of Phantasy Star 3, Generations of Doom, which featured an innovative and original branching storyline, which spans three generations of characters and can be altered depending on which character the protagonist of each generation marries, leading to four possible endings. Final Fantasy IV 1991 helped popularize dramatic storytelling in RPGs alongside the earlier Phantasy Star games and introduced the hybrid active time battle system in 1991. Final Fantasy Adventure, the first in the Mana series, introduced the ability to kill townspeople, something that most RPGs still lack today. The most important RPG that year, however, was Final Fantasy IV, one of the first role-playing games to feature a complex, involving plot, placing a much greater emphasis on character development and personal relationships, and pioneering the whole concept of dramatic storytelling in an RPG. It also introduced a new battle system, the active time battle system, developed by Hiroyuki Ito, where the timekeeping system does not stop on the battle screen. Each character has an ATB meter that gradually fills, and the player is allowed to issue a command to that character once the meter is full. The fact that enemies can attack or be attacked at any time is credited with injecting urgency and excitement into the combat system. The ATB combat system was considered revolutionary for being a hybrid between turn-based and real-time combat, with its requirement of faster reactions from players appealing to those who were more used to action games. That same year, Cree Tech's Metal Max was an early non-linear, open-ended, post-apocalyptic, vehicle combat RPG that lacked a predetermined story path and instead allowed the player to choose which missions to follow in whatever order while being able to visit any place in the game world. The ending also can be determined by the player's actions, while they can continue playing the game even after the ending the game. Also allowed the player to choose the character classes for each player character as well as create and modify the tanks used in battle. The Metal Max series continued to allow tank customization and open-ended gameplay, while also allowing the player to obtain an ending at almost any time, particularly Metal Saga, which could be completed with an ending scenario just minutes into the game, making it the shortest possible RPG. Telenet Japan released a console remake of its 1988 action platform RPG Exile, which was controversial, with a plot revolving around a time-traveling Crusades-era Syrian Islamic assassin who assassinates various religious, historical figures as well as modern-day political leaders, with similarities to the present-day Assassin's Creed action game series. While the gameplay of Exile involved taking drugs that increase or decrease statistics and affect the player's heart rate, displayed using a heart monitor in 1992, Final Fantasy V improved on the ATB system by introducing a time gauge to indicate to the player which character character's turn is next, and it expanded the job system by offering more customization options with more than 22 job classes and giving each character greater flexibility by allowing them to learn secondary abilities from each job before changing classes. The job and ATB systems continued to be used in later Final Fantasy titles, and helped differentiate the series from the character class systems and turn-based systems of traditional CRPGs. 1992 also saw the release of Dragon Quest V, a game that has been praised for its involving, emotional family-themed narrative divided by different periods of time, something that has appeared in very few video games before or since. It has also been credited as the first known video game to feature a playable pregnancy, a concept that has since appeared in later games such as Story of Seasons, The Sims 2 and Fable 2. Dragon Quest V's monster collecting mechanic, where monsters can be defeated, captured, added to the party, and gain their own experience levels, also influenced many later franchises such as Pokemon, Digimon and Dokapon. In turn, the concept of collecting everything in a game, in the form of achievements or similar rewards, has since become a common trend in video games. Dragon Quest V also expanded the AI tactics system of its predecessor by allowing each ally's AI routines to be set individually. Shin Megami Tensei, released in 1992 for the SNES, introduced an early moral alignment system that influences the direction and outcome of the storyline. It gave the player the freedom to choose between three different paths, chaos, law, and neutral, none of which is portrayed as right or wrong. The deep personal choices the player makes throughout the game affects the protagonist's alignment, leading to different possible paths and multiple endings. This has since become a hallmark of the Megami Tensei series. Another non-linear RPG released that year was Romancing Saga, an open-world RPG by Square that offered many choices and allowed players to complete quests in any order, with the decision of whether or not to participate in any particular quest affecting the outcome of the storyline. The game also allowed players to choose from 8 different characters, each with their own stories that start in different places and offer different outcomes. Romancing Saga thus succeeded in providing a very different experience during each run through the game, something that later nonlinear RPGs such as Saga Frontier and Fable had promised but were unable to live up to. The Saga series has since become known for its open-ended gameplay. The series is also known for having an activity-based progression system instead of experience levels, and since Romancing Saga, a combo system where up to 5 party members can perform a combined special attack unlike other RPGs at the time. Romancing Saga also required characters to pay mentors to teach them abilities, whether it was using certain weapons or certain proficiencies like opening a chest or dismantling a trap. Data East's Heracles no Echo 3, written by Kazushige Najima, introduced the plot element of a nameless immortal suffering from amnesia, and Najima would later revisit the amnesia theme in Final Fantasy VII and Glory of Heracles. Heracles Climax Entertainment's Landstalker, The Treasures of King Knoll was an early isometric RPG that combined the gameplay of an open-world action RPG with an isometric platformer, alongside an emphasis on varied puzzle-solving as well as strong characterization and humorous conversations. The TurboGrafx CD port of Dragon Knight 2 released that year was also notable for introducing erotic adult content to consoles, though such content had often appeared in Japanese computer RPGs since the early 1980s. That same year, Game Arts began the Lunar series on the Sega CD with Lunar, the Silver Star, one of the first successful CD-ROM RPGs, featuring both voice and text, and considered one of the best RPGs in its time. The game was praised for its soundtrack, emotionally engaging storyline, and strong characterization. It also introduced an early form of level scaling where the bosses would get stronger depending on the protagonist's level, a mechanic that was later used in Enix's The Seventh Saga and extended to normal enemies in Square's Romancing Saga 3 and later Final Fantasy VIII. In 1993, Square's Secret of Mana, the second in the Mana series, further advanced the action RPG subgenre with its introduction of cooperative multiplayer into the genre. The game was created by a team previously responsible for the first 3 Final Fantasy titles, Nasir Gebelli, Koichi Ishii, and Hiromichi Tanaka. It was intended to be one of the first CD-ROM RPGs, as a launch title for the SNES CD add-on, but had to be altered to fit on to a standard game cartridge after the SNES CD project was dropped. The game received considerable acclaim for its innovative pausable real-time battle system, the Ring Command menu system, its innovative cooperative multiplayer gameplay, where the second or third players could drop in and out of the game at any time rather than players having to join the game at the same time, and the customizable AI settings for computer-controlled allies. The game has influenced a number of later action RPGs that same year also. Saw the release of Phantasy Star IV, The End of the Millennium, which introduced the use of pre-programmable combat maneuvers called macros, a means of setting up the player's party AI to deliver custom attack combos. Madu Monogatari, a 1989 MSX and PC-98 computer RPG ported to the Game Gear handheld console in 1993, had several unique features, including magic-oriented turn-based combat that completely lacked physical attacks, and the replacement of numerical statistics with visual representations, where the protagonist's condition is represented by her facial expressions and sprite graphics while experience is measured in jewels that encircle the screen, with the only visible numerical statistic being the collected gold. That year also saw the release of Romancing Saga 2, which further expanded the non-linear gameplay of its predecessor. While in the original Romancing Saga, scenarios were changed according to dialogue choices during conversations, Romancing Saga 2 further expanded on this by having unique storylines for each character that can change depending on the player's actions, including who is chosen, what is said in conversation, what events have occurred, and who is present in the party. In 1994, Final Fantasy VI moved away from the medieval setting of its predecessors, instead being set in a steampunk environment. The game received considerable acclaim, and is seen as one of the greatest RPGs of all time, for improvements such as its broadened thematic scope, plotlines, characters, multiple-choice scenarios, and variation of play. Final Fantasy VI dealt with mature themes such as suicide, war crimes, child abandonment, teen pregnancy, and coping with the deaths of loved ones. Square's Live A Live, released for the Super Famicom in Japan, featured 8 different characters and stories, with the first 7 unfolding in any order the player chooses, as well as 4 different endings. The game's ninja chapter in particular was an early example of stealth game elements in an RPG, requiring the player to infiltrate a castle, rewarding the player if the entire chapter can be completed without engaging in combat. Other chapters had similar innovations, such as Akira's chapter, where the character uses telepathic powers to discover information. That same year saw the release of the 3DO console port of the 1991 PC RPG Knights of Zentar, which had introduced a unique pausable real-time battle system, where characters automatically attack based on a list of different AI scripts chosen by the player. Robotrek by Quintet and Ancient was a predecessor to Pokémon in the sense that the protagonist does not himself fight, but sends out his robots to do so like Pokémon. Robotrek was designed to appeal to a younger audience, allowed team customization, and each robot was kept in a ball. Late 1990s. In 1995, Square's Chrono Trigger raised the standards for the genre, with certain aspects that were considered revolutionary in its time, including its non-linear gameplay, branching plot, more than 10 different endings, plot-related side quests, a unique battle system with innovations such as combo attacks, and lack of random encounters. It also introduced the concept of new game, though this game mode has its origins in the original Legend of Zelda. Chrono Trigger also reintroduced the concept of time travel in RPGs, which had rarely been dealt with in video games since the original Final Fantasy. That same year, Square's Romancing Saga 3 featured a storyline that could be told differently from the perspectives of up to 8 different characters and introduced a level scaling system where the enemies get stronger as the characters do, a mechanic that was later used in Final Fantasy VIII. Enix's Dragon Quest VI introduced an innovative scenario with a unique real-world and dream-world setting, which seems to have had an influence on the later Square role-playing games Chrono Cross and Final Fantasy X. Dragon Quest VI also improved on the inventory management of its predecessors with the addition of a bag to store extra items. Meanwhile, Quintet's Terranigma allowed players to shape the game world through town-building simulation elements, expanding on its 1992 predecessor Soul Blazer, while Square's Seiken Densetsu 3 allowed a number of different possible storyline paths and endings depending on which combination of characters the player selected. Beyond the Beyond introduced a turn-based battle system dubbed the Active Playing System, which allows the player to increase the chances of landing an improved attack or defending from an attack by pressing the X button at the correct time during battle, similar to the timing-based attacks in the later game Final Fantasy.